So I logged into my Google link shortening account the other day just to check out my links and the analytics and so forth. And I noticed that they have a new sign up there. Google are discontinuing their link shortening service as of March 2019. I was devastated and I thought, how am I gonna be able to get my analytics for all my links? So that's when I'd created a tool using Google Sheets to easily convert over all my Google short links into Bitly links. Stick around if you want to check out what I did and how you can do it too. It's Tech Quiz time. Hey guys, Jonathan here with Tech Quiz Time, where I create technology tutorial and review videos. In this video, I'm going to be going over the steps that I took to convert my Google short links into Bitly short links, and it is really quick and really easy, actually. Before I go any further though, I just wanted to mention NordVPN. It's my new VPN of choice, especially when it comes to circumventing media streaming services in other countries. You know what I mean. So if you want to check them out and help out the channel, there is a link down in the description below. So I'll run you through quickly how you can export your links from Google and then import them into the Google Sheet, which will then automatically import them into Bitly. So with that said, let's fire up the Google link shortening service at googl.gl. And you'll notice here that there is an export to CSV. So you want to click on that, and what that will do is it'll export all your Google links into an CSV file. So once you've done that and you've got your CSV file, you can do this one of two ways. You can open it in Google Sheets itself by importing it, or you can open it in Excel if you've got that on your computer. So I'm in Excel here, and all you need to do is expand the column with the actual links in it and select those cells and make a copy. Now, one of the things to note here is my sheet is limited to 100 at a time. So just be aware when you're copying your links. So the next thing you'll need to do is you'll need to click on this Bitly link that I've provided down in the description below to open up a shared version of my Google Sheet. Now, what you'll need to do here is once you've opened it up, you'll need to make a copy of it to your Google Drive. So to do that, you go to the File menu and go make a copy. Of course, make sure you're logged into your Google account. So once you've made a copy, open up that one, and now you'll be able to edit this. So two pieces of information you'll need here are from your Bitly account. So make sure you've set one up already, because we're gonna need a username and an API key. Now to get your API key from Bitly, what you'll need to do is log into your account, and up in the top right-hand corner where the little icon with four lines are, click onto that, then click on Settings, then click on Advanced Settings, then click on API Support. Here you'll be given your login and your API key that you'll need to input into the Google Sheet that you've just made a copy of. So once you've got those details in there, maybe you might need to go back and copy those links again because it's probably overwritten. Copy those links only up to 100 and then paste them into the URL to shorten column. Give this a little bit of time, but what it will do is it will go through and using the API access, import all of those links into your Bitly account. How awesome is that? So now you didn't need to put all those in there at all. You can put a name beside them just for your records, but what will happen is Bitly will actually scrape those pages and have a look for what the name of the page is. So all the hard work is done. So now you're able to track your Bitly links, especially when Google stops you from tracking the analytics on your Google short links in 2019. If this helped you, make sure you leave me a comment down below and let me know, because I know there's going to be a lot of YouTubers out there and just general people that use Google Shortlink. They're going to be affected by this, so this is probably going to help quite a few people, I think. Do you want to see more awesome tech gadget reviews and tutorials? Then make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell icon so you get notified whenever I release a new video, which is usually Monday and Friday, depending on your time zone. With a new baby, it can be a little bit mixed up, but that's my schedule at the moment. Did you like this video? Then make sure you give it a big thumbs up and also consider checking out my Patreon campaign where you can help support my channel. You can help the community grow here by sharing this video on Facebook groups or even Reddit. Actually, especially Reddit. Reddit users are gonna love this video. Also, don't forget to check out these other awesome videos that I've created here. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Why, Google? Why?